Hey guys, how you doing? I hope you're well. Welcome back to Sim UK and NAUTIS, Home Ship Simulating Simulator. I think that's... I'm getting tired, I think. we're going to sail... No, we're going to go backwards and we're going to make a turn. So, depending on which way the turn is, I think we'll be alright with this. But we've just got to reverse the rudder and... add a bit of bow thruster as well. That was weird. All right, looks like we're up and running already. Hang on. I get a sneaky suspicion. Yeah. For some reason, every now and then, this disconnects the SciTech panel. I don't know why. So we've got to give it, a bit of that, and I want the front to go left. Let's drop the engine, because I think this is going to be hard as hell. Turning in quite nicely, but the front end is going to go out too far and we're going to turn too quickly. I will be shocked if I can do this first time. Especially seeing as how the conning tower isn't on. There we go, that helps. This is going to be very painful. So by putting a bit of forward propeller in, I should turn the arse end of the ship out. Bugger, this is going to be harder than I thought. Right, okay. So I'm going to reverse till we get about 2.5 knots. Then I'm going to put the bow thrusters on. And we're going to go from there. I think that's all we need to do. So reverse thrusters are on full. Bow thrusters are on. Let's get everybody facing in the right direction. Maybe the bow thrusters are too powerful to kick in this early. So I think we're just going to have the same problem, right? It is a bow thrusters and rudder thing, isn't it? I need to turn that way. I need to turn the opposite way to the way I want to go. Right, okay, I've got it. Let's restart. There's like a perfect moment to start moving back, start turning in, and I don't really have any idea at all when that would be. Reversing a ship of this size is so unbelievably different to driving it forwards, sailing it forwards, I should say. Right. Side thrusters coming in. Slow everything down. Not convinced I'm turning this rudder the correct way. Yeah, it must be. Nose of the ship went out. It's going to be challenging. Right, so I have to put the thrusters on. We have to be going backwards. 2.5 knots. It's probably, maybe 2 knots is fast enough. I don't know if I can steer the rudder at 2 knots, though. That's the only problem. Am I turning the right way? I feel like I'm turning the wrong way. I'm not turning the wrong way. Okay. So I was turning the correct way, but the rudder was having no effect whatsoever. Oh man, this is going to be tough. When I'm going backwards, I need to turn to the right so that the rudder turns to the right, thus. But does that streamline the boat to turn that way? I think it does. Ah, this is confusing. All right, let's back up. We'll get some pace and then we'll Yeah, that's good, that's good. Right, so we go 15% reverse thrusters. Turn the rudder 100%. Yeah, that's looking good. Bit of bow thrusters just to give us that little bit of turn. Right, now I feel like we need to turn more. But we have to be really careful because of the front of the ship, which desperately wants to turn out really far. I've got to keep an eye on that. Keep it round about 2 knots. So that's looking good. I can turn this end round and see the front. Oh, that's looking a little bit close. Oh man, we've either got this bang on or we're just gonna screw it up. I'll be honest with you, I don't know which it is. No! Son of a bitch. That was so close to getting that right. So close to getting that right. Perhaps I need to give myself a bit more time before I turn. Let's try that. So we'll head back nice and slow and steady. We'll put a tiny amount of bow thrusters on, and that will just, it will turn us in ever so slightly and give us a better angle to get there. I'm making this up as I go along, obviously. I do not know what the correct thing to do is. Just trying to work it out as we go. Right, this is very much going to have to be on the inside. This is very much going to have to be on the outside. Watching these things. Right, let's get moving. Give it two notches of bow thrusters. Doing two knots. I'm going to hold it there. I'm going to see if that turns us in enough. Doesn't seem to be. So more bow thrusters required. Yeah, that's not. It's not turning us in anywhere near enough, is it? No bow thrusters at all, please. This is all going to be in reverse. This is really tough. I know what I should have done now. It should be bow thrusters first. Get the angle that I want and then back it up. We're not going to do it this time. It might happen. It's gonna happen. It's gonna be very close. No! Ah, it's just outside again. Okay, I've got it. I've figured it out. I know how to do it. That was close, though. That was really close. Right, I understand it now. I've got it. 100% this time we're going to do it, okay? It's like a whole new vehicle. Nothing behaves the way you expect it to. Right, side thrusters. There we go. That's the angle we want. Now reverses. Did I give it too much? I think I gave it too much. Because we're still turning 15 degrees. Yeah, that was too much. Okay. Sorry, my bad. Until you try this yourself, you won't appreciate how completely different this handles. Everything you know about sailing a ship, take that, throw it out the window. This is not doing the same thing. Right, let's do it a bit more slowly. Start turning in. Bit more bow thruster. Right, we have to kill the power because we're going too quick. Come on, bow thruster, get me round. Need to go. Honestly, this rudder does sod all at the back. It doesn't turn a thing. So the front is turning, but the back is not turning. And that is our problem. Close we are. feel like there's enough space. Stop in time here. Front end's gonna go out any second now. Damn it, we're actually going forwards. Oh man, this is so hard. I need to get the bow out first and then start backing up. I'm sure that's what I need to do. It's just not that easy. So let's go maximum bow. Kick that out as far as we can. Is that too much? Is it a bit too much? Maybe a bit too much. It needs to stop now. We need to straighten out now. Right, here we go. Here we go. Backing up at 2 knots. We're inside the marker. I think we have it this time. Still really, really tight, but we should have enough of an angle to turn, I hope. So, here goes absolutely nothing. Is that going to turn too quickly? Are we going to go outside of the buoy? Crap, we're touching it. I think we're going to fail. It hasn't failed us yet. It's a bit of a cheat. I think it's going to let us get away with that. Maybe we were just rubbing up against the edge of it and not actually touching it. Might actually do it this time. That is really tough work. Not let the bow go out the front. No, I think we're okay. Holy bananas. Right, so I've got to straighten this up now. Newfound respect for big ship captains. I'll be honest, I always thought it was a bit of a cushy little number job. It always felt like it wasn't exactly hard work. I realise now there's an awful lot of skill and complexity to everything they do. And obviously the stakes are massive. Look at this. I cannot correct this turn at all. Scenario completed, but I don't really felt like I had that under control particularly. Got 20 out of 20. That is some going. That is some going. All right. Turn around in a narrow stretch. Right, this should all be bow thrusters. With a little bit of throttle just to keep us in position. Oh, hello. Sail forward into the narrow area, turn around and sail out again. Stay away from the buoys and don't hit the sides. The scenario ends when you cross the line. 15 minutes. This is like the U-turn one. Alright, well, let's get moving. Oh, we got the rudders the opposite way around, isn't it? sure I don't hit the tail end. Pretty good. How's the bow looking though? Do we have enough space on the bow? We're running out of space. Going to slow us down ever so slightly. So we're turning more on a pivot. Jolly good fun this. I'm hoping there are going to be some scenarios where we have to put these skills into practice. Right, I've got to be careful not to touch this buoy now. Tight space. Kind of scary. Alright. Maximum side thrusters again. Scenario complete. Wonderful. That was fun. I enjoyed that. Oh, I've got to get over the line, haven't I? I've forgotten about that. Short work of that one. The going forwards I'm pretty good at. It's going backwards is hell on earth. I can understand why a lot of big ships have rear thrusters as well as bow thrusters. Stern thrusters, I should say. Okay. Sail out of a harbour. You start inside a small harbour, sail out of the harbour without touching the quays, and make a turn to starboard. Make sure you stay on the starboard side of the canal. Yeah. Okay. Fantastic. Little look at our scenario. That's very nice. Right, so we're going to have one chap out here watching the inside. One chap out here watching the outside. And I think we're pretty much good to go. Not give it 100%. Let's try and do this properly. Let's give it 30%. From the quay side. Okay, so I'm up on the bow. I want to know when we are. Coming up on the edge of the quayside there. Knots, I think that's fast enough. Right, bow thrusters maximum to starboard side. Start turning in. It's possible I started turning in a bit too late there. Ah! Got caught out by the rudder again. It's counteracting the bow thruster. That's why we weren't turning. I have the same problem when I play Rise of Flight, because the throttle configurations in World War One were the opposite way round. First time every time, except for all the times that it's not first time. All right. I wonder what the acceptable speed limit is. This is the perfect scenario for them to tell you how fast you ought to be manoeuvring in a tight harbour like this, but they never mention it. They never say anything. Right, we'll just speed gun it out of here. No reason why we shouldn't. straighten up. Lovely stuff. I'm a little bit, in fact, I'm really quite far over to the middle. I shouldn't be that far over to the middle. Taking liberties there. I think we're just inside. I think we're just okay, yeah. Just about made it. Bit lazy on the steering. Sail into a narrow harbour. Okay, let's do that. You start on the canal with an initial speed of 5 knots, turn into the harbour without touching the quays and come to a full stop between the buoys. Okay. Here come the buoys. Turned in too early. Just a little bit too early. Not super, super too early, but too early. That looks so much closer than that does, don't you think? To me, that feels like we're in it. We're hitting it already. But actually, we're not. Right. Do we have this side? Quite a bit. Okay. Somebody once said to me, never sail any faster in a harbour than we would like to hit something. I've always thought that was very good advice. I've tried to stick to it ever since. Straighten up, straighten up, straighten up, straighten up. Nice leisurely sail into the buoys then. I wouldn't say that was what I just did then was very good at all. If I had sort of 10 goes at it, I think I'd make a much better job of it. Certainly more confident a job, but first you don't succeed, try and try again. Right, we're looking pretty square. That looks good to me. Straighten up. The marker, so I need to slow down now. I think I should have probably started braking quite a bit earlier. Whoops. Ah, we did it. We did it. We did it. We did it. How many left? Practice exam. Go around the track. 45 minutes. Okay. So we got two exams and then we'll go to New York. So I think we'll put that into another video. But yes, Manoeuvring 1, part 3 is over. Thank you for watching. And I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. I certainly did. And I hope you join me for the next one. Take care. Bye for now.